that. It's nice to see you. And it's nice to be back here. I guess probably this is as much home church for us as any of the others we visit. We started coming here just after we formed the group while we were still located in State College. And we have been here each year, I guess 8 or 9 years, Joni? How long? Over a long time. And it's been one of those marvelous traditions that we have appreciated very much. As most of you know, it's not often possible for us to bring lights into church because many of the churches where we worship were built sort of before recreation and didn't plan to accommodate all of these things. It's wonderful to be able to use them, and especially when we're having a special presentation such as we are tonight during this Lenten season. It's good to see some friends who have been part of our work ever since the beginning, some folks we hope will be part of the recreation program, because we want your help and your prayers and your concern. And I'll be telling you more about a lot of the things we do as we move into the program tonight. But thank you for coming. We want you to respond to tonight's program as you feel led to respond. If you feel like applauding, by all means applaud. And share in the program as the Spirit of God moves in your heart. This year, for the first time, Recreation is using an overture. Most of you know that every year we change the theme of our church program. This year the theme is heaven. I wrote the words to most of the songs you'll be hearing. David Kazee wrote the music. And that particular package of music that Recreation will be presenting tonight along that theme is one that we've developed with the hope that perhaps you and I might think of heaven as a place of a little more consistency and reality than we are often inclined to do because of the hurry in our everyday lives. When I wrote the words to the opening song, I handed them to David Kazee, and I said, David, what does Jesus look like? And I said, now don't answer me, but sit down at the keyboard and play what you feel when you consider that question. And so he did. And what he played is what we use as the overture to this year's program. We've called it Overture to Redemption. David said when he started to consider that question, his mind was confused. He tried to see a physical presence. And then he said he came to a place where he realized that the physical presence was not nearly as important as a spiritual relationship. And so he had a great personal peace about that. You'll hear the confusion in the first part of the overture, and you'll sense it in the lighting that Jack Helm does for you. And then David came to the place of peace, and you'll feel that in the overture when the harp begins to play. And he said as he got to that point, he started reading the words to the opening song. The song is called, We Shall See His Face. And he said all of a sudden he began to realize that one day the spiritual reality and the physical presence would be one. And we would know Jesus face to face. As we start into our time of worship together, let us ask you to consider with us what I asked David to consider. What do you think Jesus looks like? it sure is a pleasure being here with you this evening. Before we continue our program, we would like to introduce ourselves. My name is George Moore. I'm from Williamsport, Pennsylvania. This is my first year with Recreation, and I sing 10.
Hello, my name is Rachel Plakos. I'm from Vermilion, Ohio. This is my first year with Recreation, and I sing soprano.
My name is Tim Zechman. My home is in Middleburg, Pennsylvania. This is my first year with Recreation, and I sing baritone. And I have two special people here this evening, my parents, Mark and Carol Zechman.
Hello, my name is Judy Fitch. I'm from Dallas, Pennsylvania. This is my second year in Recreation, and I sing alto.
Hello, I'm Jay Muller. My home's in Sealandsville, Pennsylvania. This is my second year with the group, and I sing tenor, and I as well have some very special people here with me this evening. My parents, Jim and Sandy Muller.
Hello, my name is Joanne Kloss. My home is in Stroudsburg, Pennsylvania. This is my second year with Recreation, and I sing soprano.
Good evening. My name is Dr. Abrom. My hometown is in Rutherford, New Jersey. This is my first year with the group, and I sing soprano.
Hello, my name is Laurie, DeWire. I'm from Hughesville, Pennsylvania. This is my first year in Recreation, and I sing alto. And I have three very special people here with me this evening. My parents' friend, Jane DeWire, and my little brother, Matt.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. There are some more members of our organization that we'd like you to know also. First are our other two performers, and they're in the back.
Good evening. My name is John Imhof. My hometown is in Ship Bottom, New Jersey, and I'm Recreation's sound engineer.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Jack Helm. My hometown is in York, Pennsylvania. This is my second year with the group as the lighting technician.
We also have our road manager with us tonight. He sang with Recreation for 5 years and is now working with Mr. Brooks while he develops his own singing career. Won't you please welcome from Altoona, Pennsylvania, Mr. Jim Worthing. And there's one more special person we'd like you to know. She's the lovely lady who designs our costumes and serves as our mom on the road. She's our director's wife. Won't you please greet Mrs. Carolyn Brooks.
Thank you. I feel like
He poured all of that into this next number. The song is called Right Under Jesus, and in it are thoughts about angels, the book of life, the plan of salvation, and about heaven. Knowing that Jim Worthing would be with us this year, Mr. Brooks asked David Kazee to score Right Under Jesus for Jim's rather remarkable voice. He comes to sing for us now, Right Under Jesus.
I dreamed I died and went to heaven,
where?
And came upon the pearly gates.
Oh.
I rang the bell, someone answered.
Who?
It was an angel, tall and straight. I was surprised. I thought St.
Peter's
would be the one at heaven's door.
Why, of course.
He'll be back soon. He's just gone fishing. Then open up and let me enter. My race is run, I'm on the fast. Just check the book, I'm listed in it. I will bear robes, father's wise.
What?
Your name's not here.
What?
The angel muttered.
How can that be?
What can we do to prove your play? Look in the front, the crimson pages.
Oh, please.
I missed it under Jesus' name. He said it's here, right under Jesus.
Right here.
This book of life confuses me.
Oh,
but hang on tight for just a minute.
Okay.
I'll see if I can find the key.
Confused.
The angels' looks and the apostle, the judgment. servants.
Servants.
And when they fall, they lose their place.
What the
but when you fail, you found redemption.
I see.
Because of God's amazing grace, He raised the man in crimson cages. I mentioned them the day I came. They got the book.
About the resurrection and about heaven. Everything we need to know, but not everything we want to know. In the 11th chapter of John, there's an intriguing story that causes us to wonder about some of those things that we don't understand and to think ahead to the time when God will supply the answers to all those questions. We're told in that chapter that Jesus is called to the home of some of his friends because a member of the family died. He arrived there 4 days after his friend was placed in the grave and went immediately to the tomb. The Bible says he wept. And then with that voice of authority that only the Son of God could have used, he spoke. And his friend came back from the dead. Now have you ever wondered what must have gone through the mind of that man? He was dead, and then he was alive, and yet he knew he had to die again. But he knew at least one thing more. He knew that his next resurrection would be a passage into another world. We ask you now to step back with us 2,000 years and through the imagination of our director, consider the truths we might have learned if we had heard that story from the lips of the man in whose life that miracle was worked. That friend of Jesus called Lazarus.
How strange it all seems that I should still be here on earth, and how not long ago, in the depths of the grave, Jesus gave, as it were, a new birth. Now the master has
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Recreation will be back in just a few moments to sing some more for us. And while they are stepping out to do some things that we think are important to the program, let me say some things to you about them. First of all, it occurred to me that it was at this church just a year ago that we had the opportunity to hear Tim Zechman sing. We had heard him before, and the first time we heard him, we did not have a slot open where his particular voice range fit. And so last year, when we knew we were going to have that, we called and asked him to meet us. He came here and sang for us and went immediately into the recreation path. We took him right then. And I'm not sure what that was, but maybe a tribute to Tim, John? Is that what that was? That's good. You and I will enjoy that while we talk about it now, and then we'll get a little stronger about it later, probably. Happened at a good time. Sometimes that kind of thing can really get you. But we got to hear Tim, and what a blessing that young man is. Wow. He's not only a talented singer, but a remarkable youngster. And so it's kind of good for us to get to come back here where we had a chance to hear him. While we're on that subject, we change personnel, as you know, each year. Some young people leave us and some come to join us. And one of the young ladies who will be coming to join us this next year is here tonight. And I guess this is the first time I've had a chance to introduce her, isn't it? I'd like you to meet from Milton, Pennsylvania, Susie Sleece. Right here. Susie will join us the 1st of August, and by the 20th of August, she will be part of the new recreation group, and they'll be on their way to California. And so she'll have a very busy time beginning the 1st of August. We'll gather all the music in advance, and she'll learn that, come in knowing the music, and we'll go right into choreography. And of course, while she's with us those first 2 or 3 weeks, the other group will still be singing, and so they'll rehearse during the day and sing at night, and then the other young people will leave us and this group will head out to do its work. And the work of the next group will be essentially what the work of this group has been. I thought tonight when I was considering that we have been here so many times that it makes me very comfortable to realize that we have been so often among people and have talked so often about our program, that those people know us and know the integrity of what we're doing and see and observe that the things we talk about in church are the things that are actually what we're about. I think most of you know that it would be entirely possible, maybe you don't, maybe you're not into the entertainment business much, but it would be entirely possible to take a group like this and actually earn an incredible amount of money if you wanted the group to be an entertainment group. We know that. We know where the opportunities are, and we know how the program could work. And if we decided to do that, we could do that starting next week, because all those opportunities are open for this kind of program. But we didn't get into this for that reason. We came into this business because when I was at Penn State on the faculty, I saw that there were people all over the state and nation who really needed help that could be provided by young people who were dedicated to service and to the Lord. And so when we started Recreation, that was the reason for the organization, and we've stayed with that because we think God is using it. And as you know, in the past few years, this has been the only organization providing live entertainment consistently and nationwide for our hospitalized veterans. The USO doesn't do that anymore. Recreation does it. And the choice to stay a service organization is a choice to ask for help, because we can't earn enough money to keep doing the things that serve other people if we take our time to do the service concerts. And that's why when we come to church, we ask you to help us. The most difficult thing I do in this whole organization is to ask for help. But I believe that God wants us to do that. I think He wants us to continue to sing for the people in these institutions. Every year we go back to VA medical centers and we ask about people we remember there. And every year, some of them have died since we saw them last. Many of them spend their lives in those places and never see a program like this until we come, or unless Katie and her band go there for us. And you folks help pay those bills. Next week, they'll be going to Western New York to sing in VA medical centers. In 3 weeks, they'll be heading out into the Midland of our United States, singing in about 14 other states. Traveling all day long, working hard, singing at night, getting a little bit of sleep, and back 300 miles or more the next day to sing for people who need them. And it's nice to be able to come back to folks who have helped us already and tell you that we're right here among you. You see us, you know us, and you know we're telling you honestly what we do, and to ask you to help us again. We'll use your help as early as next week to help get these young people to New York, where they'll be gone for 4 days singing for hospitalized veterans. We need all the help you can give us, and we'll be faithful with your money. We'll put it right where we've told you it's going. Your ushers will be coming in a moment to take that offering, and we'd like to ask you to help us all you can. We do need that help, and we'll appreciate your sharing. As the ushers come, will you join me in a moment of prayer? Our Heavenly Father, we thank Thee that Thou hast given us an opportunity to serve. And we pray tonight that the money which is given by the people of God who love Thee and who wanted to help others will go directly into that channel, that Thy Spirit shall oversee its use, and that those who need us and Thee will find help. For we ask it in Jesus' name and for His sake. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Don't move yet, gang. Stand right there. Most of you people who have followed recreation for a little while know that I wrote Thunder and Lightning some years ago and that we used it in another format. We asked Dan Walkenworth this year to take it and rewrite it for us to give it more dramatic impact. And you've just heard the first full presentation of it since they've had time to work it in the studio. And I'm very grateful for what they did. That is the single most difficult piece of music we have ever even attempted. And we would not have been able to do it had it been necessary for me to teach it to them. I could not have done it. We have a remarkable group this year. And the vocal coaching that we get for this group comes from one of our own members who just graduated in voice from Susquehanna University. And the precision and the majesty of that presentation, as well as the other very nice vocal sounds we're getting this year, come from two primary sources. First of all, from really hard work on the part of these young people. And secondly, from the help they get under the leadership of Rachel Plakos. They'll step out now for a moment and take off those ropes, and they'll be back to close our service for us. And Jack, if we could have some house lights here, please. And John Imhof and Jack Helm were working back there for the first time on that piece since they had a chance to hear it worked in the studio. And I think they did a tremendous job with the sound and lighting back there. And I'm grateful, Jack and John, for the work you did for us. Well, there are a lot of things to happen yet before Easter, but it'll be difficult for my heart to get any more full than I have felt here tonight in your presence and with these young people and with the story again of the crucifixion and the resurrection. If you have a copy of Thunder and Lightning, you'll recognize that the whole final section of that is new. It was early Sunday morning when Dan Walkenworth started to work on this song for me. He called and said, "Hugh, you have assumed the resurrection in Thunder and Lightning." And he said, "I'd like to present it. Would you write me some words for the final section?" And I wrote those and sent them back to Dan, and you'll recognize that they were all new. It was early Sunday morning at the dawning of the day. And the whisper of the wind took on the sound of Jesus' name. The earth began to tremble in reply. The earth has trembled since that day with the sound of Jesus' name. It's a name that adults lean on and a name that children adore. The name above all names. And it is our hope and prayer that this Easter season he shall be more real to you than ever before in your life. I'd like to say thank you to each of the churches in this council of churches that has participated in making this program possible, to the pastors who are here tonight for your love and courtesy, help in this, to the wonderful ladies who prepared that delicious meal for us, and to you for coming. We hope we'll get to see you many, many times along the way. Recreation's music tonight has been recorded and is available back in the vestibule. Stop and take a look at it if you're interested in keeping their music. The song that Jimmy sang and the overture to redemption, and we shall see his face, talk about heaven, Kevin Medley, you sang with us. All of those things are on the new tape. They're recording Thunder and Lightning right now. They did part of it on Friday, and they'll be doing some more of it this next week. So some of it's there. We'd like you to stop and take a look. Before you get away, if you ever talk about scheduling recreation anytime, you'll talk to the people, to the lady who has been our partner in this business since we started it. She and her husband have worked with Carolyn and me and everything that recreation has done. And if you've not met her and her husband Sam, I want you to know Joni Patterson. She's right here at the front. I think Sam is out with one of the girls. Sarah is here, and they have two daughters, Sarah and Jim. And so if you talk to anyone about scheduling recreation, you'll be talking to Joni. She manages all the intricate parts of keeping this organization on the road. And we're grateful that they could be with us tonight. Stay for a moment after our young people have sung the final song, and let them greet you. They'll want to be out here to shake hands with you. May we bow together for our closing prayer. Our Heavenly Father, we thank Thee tonight for this season and for what it means to each of us. We ask that the Spirit of God shall in this moment apply the truth of the crucifixion and resurrection to our hearts and help us to know that it was because of the shed blood of Christ on Calvary's hill that we have the promise of heaven and of eternal life. And cause us to go from here to tell all the people we meet that that blood will never lose its power, but that anyone who comes to Jesus can find redemption in and through Him. For we ask it in His name and for His sake. Amen.
Thank you.